guy, and he is quite a guy. He was born in East North Carolina, I'm afraid, around the backfields. He learned to dance and was a major influence by his father, who they called the Jitterbug Man. In the 50s, the late 50s, he started going to Atlantic Beach and all the hot spots around Eastern North Carolina. He danced whenever he could, but like all most of us anyway, during that era, he was a poor boy and he'd go to Atlantic Beach and dance all night, catch a couple of hours of sleep in the car and go work in the back of it. He made his way from Eastern North Carolina to OD and hit all of the spots here too. So he has been dancing all his life, really. But in 1961, he did a phenomenal thing. And it's hard for me to talk about his dancing as much as I love it because of this. He joined the Army in 1961 and he served his country for over 30 years. Our country. He didn't have any easy assignments during this period. You know, he was airborne, he was special forces, he was, you name it, we probably can't ask him some questions because he's done some things that he can't talk about. But he was one heck of a soldier with over 30 years of serving our country. We've had two of those. One of them sits over here, but not many enlisted men make the rank of commanding sergeant major, and he was one for many years. And I'd like to tell you, the chest full of medals that he had. But I will ask you to read those on his bio, because it's worth reading. All the big, stuff that I never thought about in my life. I think I got three or four. That was in Vietnam. And he did Vietnam all the way to Kuwait. He was in Kuwait. And everything in between. After the Army, though, he found his way back home and found out there was still dancing. Oh, geez. He was thrilled to death. And he hasn't missed a function that I know of where he could go boogie-woogie since that day. I have never seen anybody smile more or have a sweeter, kinder disposition. And he just doesn't care about anything except having a big time dancing. I mean, he just loves it. I would love for Mr. actually retired Sergeant Major, commanding Sergeant Major, James Parker, to please come. What a guy. Thank you, Barry Young, for introducing me.
Not even a heap of trouble. Anyway,
tip of his family mentors. In the early days, my mom told me one day, bless her heart, she's looking down on me right now. Probably chastising me for saying what I'm trying to say. Anyway, because she was a religious person. But my daddy was a little bit on the other side of the field. And anyway, my mama told me one day, she said, James, she said, I need you to stay here. JL's coming over here, and we're going to go find his daddy. I said, I was about 12, 10, 11 years old. I said, where's my daddy, mama? She said, he's at one of the dance halls. And so it went downhill from there. So, anyway, the only thing I can say, the anchor's going to fall far from the tree. Let me say something. When you come in to Myrtle Beach, come down Main Street, and you got Hoskins on the right, and you got Jesus House is over on the left, there's a curtain that comes down. And God knows we all turned 17, 18, 19, 20 years old. And I want all of you ladies to stand up, please, please, boy, stand up. Stand up. Because if it weren't you, we wouldn't be a shag dance. There's nothing any more important. In those early days when I was dancing in Atlantic Beach to see those young ladies, God, I love ladies. I love them. Love them then, I love them now. But to see them dance, they get down and do this thing like this here. Oh, it makes your heart stop. If you don't love yes, you got a problem. You got a problem. I know, Wanda, you're going to kill me. You gave me 2 minutes, and I've gone over my time. But let me say one more thing, and I'm going to get out of here. I was in Ducks one night, and there were people down playing golf in Pennsylvania. And I danced one time. They come off the floor, and they grabbed me 3 or 4 couples. And they said, how long have you been doing this? I said, a long time. She said, well, we really enjoy watching you dance. I said, well, where are you from? She said, Pennsylvania. She said, why do y'all come? And then I asked the question, why do you come down? And they said, well, we enjoy watching this. I said, well, I'm proud that you enjoy watching this. She said, but I'm having a problem. I said, what's that problem? She says, all my friends in Pennsylvania want to know why we come to watch you guys dance on the SOS and Midwinter and the DJ Throwdown and all that stuff. Can you explain to me how to explain it to them? I said, it's unexplainable. You can't talk about it. It comes from the heart. Thank you. God bless you. I love you. And God bless our troops.
Look, he's going to dance with Maryland, and now we believe. Thank you, Bill.
Oh!
true American hero.
Soldiers in the world. I get emotional when I talk about this. They support our soldiers. They're doing all they can do.
Thank you. We got some real heroes. Terry and James Brown, Buzz Lightyear, some in.